Hey guys, it's Andy. So in this video, I'm going to show you my favorite trial closes. We know this, outside on the lot, you're making people fall in love with the car, you come inside, and then you're going to ask for their business. And the way you ask for their business is crucial. If you ask for it wrong, you can miss a sale. If you ask for it right, you get it every single time. You'll love this video, don't miss it. I'm going to show you my two or three favorite trial closes of all times. Hey guys, so here we go. Let's talk about the first 90% of the time. What are we doing? We're outside on the lot, building massive value, making the customer fall in love with us, right? Making them love the vehicle, showing them how many cool things that it has. We're surfacing the dominant buying motive, which is like why they got in the market, what they're looking for. We're making sure that all these things go right. We know in the first 90% of the time, no money exchanges hands, right? We just know that we have to make sure that they want what we have more than they want the money that they have in their pocket, so they will spend it. The last 10% of the time, that's when we negotiate, we collect 100% of the money. This video is about the transition between the first 90% of the time, when we're on the lot, to walking through those doors and asking for their business and taking them inside. So we can do the last 10%, make all the money, close the deal up, and rock and roll. So what do we call that? We call that a trial close. Okay, what is a close? A close is something that's done actually inside the office when we close the customer up. Okay, the trial close is when we ask for the customer's business, basically saying, if the deal's right, you'll take it home, right? And we want to hear them say yes. And for the very first time, we realize that if we do our job right, which we have been doing, when we come inside, if the deal looks right, they're going to take it home. We are looking for a yes. Now look, there's lots of ways to get to a good trial close. Number one, as a kid, people may say, oh, Andy, the yes ladder don't work. Yes, it does. When I was a kid, when I was 18, my manager used to say, Andy, do me a favor, go out and get 40 yeses. If you can get 40 yeses, by the time you come inside, before you ask for their business to come in and you do your trial close, they will always say yes because you've been teaching them to say yes the entire time. It's called the yes ladder, okay? That's not a trial close, but that is something that could lead up to you getting a yes on the trial close. You know, can't you see that, you know, this would be a beautiful car sitting in your driveway? Yes. Awesome. And isn't safety important to you since this car has a great safety rating? Yes. Okay, great. And then, you know, don't you love the fact that that seat has an 8-way adjustable power seating? So since you have a bad back, it's real easy for you to get comfortable in it? Yes. I'm yesing, 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 yesing. And I'm just telling you, whether you do it or not, the yes ladder works. And it works your way up to the trial close. But now that we're talking about the trial close, there are two places to do a trial close. Let me go over both of them for you, and then I'll go over exactly how I do them. Guys, I'm about to get right back to the video. I want to tell you, number one, thank you for watching this video. Please like this video if you like what you're watching right now. Click the button. Give me a thumbs up on it. Comment below. Anything you need, I got you. Also, make sure you're subscribed to the channel. Set your notification bell so every single day when I put out brand new cutting edge training videos, you can get them.
So number one, when I had a vehicle that I knew that the customer loved, and I pulled it up. She's like, oh my God, that's so beautiful. Guess what I would do? I would say, guys, you know what? Let's go for a drive real quick. Let's go check this out. Touch it, feel it, smell it. Make sure that, you know what I'm saying, you love everything about it. In the middle of the test drive, I would say, guys, do me a favor. I want you to pull this over here. There's something I want to show you. And I want to share something with you guys that I haven't shared with many people. Whenever I purchased my car myself, and obviously I'm a salesperson here at the dealership, I actually took my car here. And I want to show you the same thing that I did when I purchased my car. And do you know what? They're like, oh wow, that's nice. And guess what happens? I pull the car over there. I know exactly how I want it angled. Then I say, everybody get out of the car for just a second. I want you to see this. I have them step back with me and I say, guys, turn around. Take a look. I took your car out here for a reason. Because we're not at the dealership and I don't have all that metal behind it, I feel like it all just kind of blends in together. But this is such a nice car. I wanted to take it out here so for the first time you could envision what it would look like in your driveway. It's a beautiful car, isn't it? And they say, yes. And I say, awesome. Well, this at this point, as long as the vehicle is driving great and obviously the things that you've told me that you wanted, it has, and you can see it and envision it sitting in your driveway, if I could get the numbers to 110% of your satisfaction, it looks like this vehicle is everything you guys wanted, right? And guess what they say? They say yes. That's where I get my trial close. Now watch this. I could change it around. I could say this. So I wanted to ask you guys a question. Now that we're out here, and obviously you said you can envision it sitting in your driveway, are you guys going to be titling this car in just your name, ma'am, or are you going to be putting it in both of your names? And they say, no, probably in both our names. I'll say, oh, great. Guys, follow me back to the store. Let's rock and roll. Let's finish the test drive. And guess what? When we get back to the store, I've already asked them the trial clothes so then I can take them down. Watch this. If it's just a normal deal, and maybe let's say these customers don't have like great credit or something, okay? And I'm just making a point, and you go for a normal test drive, and you know, they're ready to buy the car, they need a car, but they're not in love with the car. Don't do the trial close out somewhere. Do that when you know you have a really hot buyer, and you're like, man, I'm gonna lock this one in strong. I'm gonna really get them emotional. And remember, the test drive is the first time that the customer envisions himself owning the car. So that trial close, it could be a good time to ask that off the lot if you have somebody in love with the car big time. But normally, or back at the dealership, when I pull it in, I always tell my customers, go ahead and pull it right there in the sold lane. That is a trial close, okay? Hey guys, so if you would, go ahead and pull the car back around to the side. That's the sold lane. That's where we park all the sold vehicles. Now watch this. If they don't say, ooh, this isn't sold yet, guess what? They may say, oh, okay, cool. That means that they know that this car could potentially be sold because they want to buy it. Does that make sense? Pull the car in the sold lane. That is a trial close, and I'm not actually asking them a question. I'm just making a statement, and I'm looking for a response back. That is called a trial close, okay? Now, let's move into other trial closes. Another trial close would be, guys, go ahead and pull it around here in the sold lane. And they say, ooh, Andy, you know, we hadn't purchased it yet, so let's wait. Oh, no, I understand. That's just where we put them whenever we're working a deal on a vehicle. You see how I backed right out of that? And then when I get out, I step back and I say, guys, it's a beautiful car, obviously fits all your needs and wants and everything that you're looking for. It drove great. I love the way the vehicle drives. Heck, I wish I had 100 of them. Cars are this nice, they don't come in very often. What I'd like to ask you is this, if I could get the numbers to 110% to your satisfaction, there's not a reason in the world why you wouldn't be ready to take it home, right? And I take my head and I shake it, okay? And they say, okay, and I say, great, follow me inside. Let me show you how easy it is to do business here. Now have them follow me. Another way you could do it, again, is going back to how they want their new car titled. How they want their new car titled is my favorite. Okay, watch how sleek this is. So I have a husband and a wife here, right? Or let's just say I had a husband here. I have one person here, it doesn't matter. I could say this, watch. So sir, now are you gonna be titling this new vehicle in just your name, or is there someone else you're gonna be adding to the loan? And they said, no, just my name. All right, great, follow me inside. And I just turn around and he follows me inside. He didn't say, I don't want the car, so I don't know how I want it titled. He said, in just my name. Guess what? That is a trial close. It is a very slight close to get someone to say, yes, I'm willing to go through the next step. Watch this. Now, sir, ma'am, obviously, I know that the vehicle's gonna be for her. Are you gonna be titling it in both your names, or are we gonna put it just in her name? Watch this. Husband says, no, we're gonna be putting it in both of our names. Guys, think about it. If they're telling you how they want their car titled, that means they're saying, yes, I would take it. Guess what I say? Beautiful. Guys, follow me inside. Let me show you how easy it is to do business here. I want to tell you, I could ask again, like I said from the beginning. Guys, if I could get the numbers 110% to your satisfaction, there's not a reason in the world why you would be ready to take it home, right? Cool. Let me show how easy it is to do business with us. Come on inside. Guess what? There you go. I could say another one. Let me try on one more trial close before we end this video. And I hope this video helps you a lot to find what you like to say and find out where's the right place to ask for the trial close and what are the different types of trial closes that you could use. There's a million of them out there. I'm just giving you a couple of my favorite. I could give you 10, but I figure I'm giving you my top three. Here's another one. And hell, maybe I'll share two more of them with you just so you have them. So it could be, guys, I'm going to ask you a question. Obviously, it seems like we found the right car. If there was one thing, and I mean just one thing, guys, that would stop you from driving that new vehicle home right now, what would that one thing be? And let's say they say, well, it'd be the deal. So what you're saying, as long as I can get the deal right, you guys would be happy to take it home, am I right? Great, guys, follow me inside. Let me show you how easy it is to do business here. That's a trial close, if there was one thing. What's the next one? The next one is this. Guys, let me ask you this. If there was from 1 to 10, being 1, I don't want it at all, or 10, I want it right now, I'll take it, right? Where do you rate this car? 1, I wouldn't take it if it was free, and 10, I love it. Where do you rate it, 1 to 10? They say 7. You say, okay, what would make it a 10? the deal. So you're saying, as long as I can get the deal right, that would make this a 10? Great, guys, follow me inside. Let me show you easy to do business with me. Guys, I want to tell you this. I'm giving you some different options, okay, for some trial closes. But my favorite and my go-to, my 99% of the time trial close is, how do you want your new vehicle titled? Are you going to be titling it in both of your names? Is it just going to be in your name? And then I want them to say, no, it's just going to be just in my name. That's all I needed. And I say, wonderful. Follow me inside. Let me show how easy it is to do business with us. You see, they wouldn't tell me how they want it titled if they didn't plan on buying it, because there would be nothing to title. So that is my magic trial closes. So I want to tell you guys, if you become deadly at your trial closes, you know where to use them, you know how to use them, you know the best places, guys, the rest is history. And guess what? You guys are going to make a bunch of money, and your customers will love you, and you'll make it very easy to transition them inside, from outside on the lot to inside the dealership without changing their state and keeping them nice and calm. Have a great day. Hey guys, I just want to tell you, thank you for watching the full video. I started when I was 18 training just like you. No matter where you're at in life, I want to tell you this. Being committed is all that it takes. I put out free training content on YouTube every single day to make sure that I can take you to the next level of life. I have over 500 free videos. Please make sure that you like the video. Shoot me a comment below and shoot me a text message. I'd love to get to know you, okay? If I haven't met you yet, 918-210-0254. Take a second, guys. Shoot me a text message. You're important to me. I have your back for life. We're going to go all the way to the top together. I appreciate you. You guys have a blessed day. Make sure you like the video, subscribe, and set your alerts for the daily training video. Thank you.